I was 11 years old and I was terrible at school. And there was a science teacher in the grade school, his name was Mr. Risk. And I just loved his class. So I hated everything else and loved one class by Mr. Risk. And because of that, I kind of took a huge interest in it. He took an interest in me, and him taking interest in me completely changed my life. So I love science, namely because it's questioning everything. It doesn't necessarily provide all the answers. I mean, I love the fact that we understand pretty much everything except for the beginning. I mean, I love that. That's an amazing thought. So we can understand everything, all that, except for the beginning. And that's what I love about science, is that it's questioning all the things that we take for granted. In some cases, providing answers, but in other cases, providing more questions. But they're interesting questions. But the thing I'm most interested in, and not just because I'm about to do a second series, is brain plasticity. And I'm really interested in what we can do with degenerative diseases, especially in Australia with an aging population. These are radical transformations that can impact all our lives. Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's, we are still at the foothills of understanding our brain and understanding what we can do to positively correct these things. And I think in the next 10 years, we will make some amazing discoveries and advancements in that area. I think there is a perception that scientists are all white coats and nerdy, although nerds rule, I love nerds, but I think there is that perception, and that kind of puts somewhat of a darker or less interesting brand around science. But the truth is, science is attacking all of the things, the ordinary things that we take for granted in our lives, and in many cases, making them better or questioning why they're there in the first place. And if I was rebranding science, which I haven't been asked to do, and that would be a very expensive question to answer, but if I was rebranding science, it would all come down to relevance. I think people are generally not interested in science, but they're interested in their lives. And science plays a fundamental role in that. And making that connection, I think, could make a huge difference for science. My message for National Science Week would be get involved. Saying science is uninteresting is like saying you're not interested in life. It's all around us. And the next time you flip on your switch, or the next time you drive your car, pause for a moment and think, how did that come about? How does that actually work? And those hows and whys is the foundation of National Science Week.